kakamustahin ko kayo. Kamusta kayo? We want to know kung kamusta kayo ngayon. And I want you to grab this moment of time to just worship the Lord. And I know that some of us are struggling sa life. Some of us has this struggles sa family, sa school. Iniisip kung kailan kaya tayo makakabalik sa school. And you know what? Ang kailangan lang natin this time is that we should come to Jesus and ask Him. And as we worship tonight, let this be a prayer. Let's go.
Oh, how I need Your grace more than my words can say. Jesus, I come. Jesus, I
Let's continue to be in the mood of worship. Let's declare tonight that Jesus is the only hope that we have. No matter the situation is, no matter how hard it is Jesus, the only hope that we have.
Raise the one who set me free. Hallelujah.
as we praise the Lord. Let's sing this. This is Amazing Grace.
Hi youth! welcome to TGIF Online Worship Service. We're so glad that you're able to join us tonight. And I know that for some of you na nakasali, naka-join sa ating on-site TGIF, I know that you were so excited and you have enjoyed the fellowship with each other and also experiencing the presence of God with us here in Zamboanga City Alliance Evangelical Church. And we're still on the second installation of our series titled Promises. And I know for some of you na andito last Saturday, you have listened to the preaching of Ate Nicole and you have learned that promises is actually God-given. Binigay ito ni God para sa atin. And there are a lot of promises that was mentioned in the Bible. And the last Saturday, Ate Nicole shared to us that God promised His presence to be with us, that He will never leave us nor forsake us. And tonight, we're going to indulge to the one of the most famous verses that we can find in the Bible, and that's actually found in Psalm 23. I know that you are aware of Psalm 23, right? And I know that for some of you, you may experience many struggles in life, like just like what David experienced right then and there, nung mga time na yun. And in these moments, like where we experience struggles and problems, we can always assure that God is a promise for us. And We are going to look deep into that promise. We're going to look deeply on what is actually mentioned in Psalm 23. But before we start, I just want to invite you to bow down your heads with me and let us pray. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we praise and thank you for granting us this wonderful time. And I pray, Lord, that whatever it is that you have prepared for us tonight, I pray, Lord, that you would open our hearts and allow us, Lord, to be reminded that you are our great shepherd and that you have great and mighty plans for us. Even though, Lord, we go through a lot of struggles and problems in life, still we know that you are our great God. So we entrust everything to your name. We entrust, Lord, all the things that you're about to reveal to us. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Now, before we dig into the Word of God, allow me to read to you Psalm 23. It says in Psalm 23, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for His name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." May the good Lord bless the reading of His word. Now, Psalm 23, ang taong nagsulat nito is actually David. And this was actually the time where David knew that he was going to face struggle in the near future, because ang daming tao na gustong mamatay si David. Ang daming people back then, or there was this prominent people who wanted David to fail. Right? And sometimes in our lives, we tend to ask that question, why are there failures and why are there people who want us to fail? And it's so normal for all of us, because I know once in a while, or maybe there were a time in the past where we have experienced this, where people wanted for us to fail. But you see, back then, while I was reading this, na-realize ko that this was actually what David wrote. And he wrote this based on how he knew or what he knew about God. Because if you're going to look at the first two verses, sabi niya pa dito, David was actually talking about God in the third person. Sabi niya pa dito, "The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters." Now, there are no reference here about David's testimony where he used that we or us or they. But here you would see that David was actually writing a very personal psalm for God. It was like sinusulat niya yung psalm na to based sa pagkakakilala niya kay Lord. And not only that, you see, this Psalm 23 is actually a psalm where it shows that though David back then was wounded and though he was experiencing struggles and problems, still, itong Psalm 23 na to, this was like a refresher for him, because this was actually a psalm written to God. Parang love letter niya for God. And here, what comforts us is because this psalm actually talks about that in the first three verses, it refers to who God is in the third person. Mapapansin nyo that when David actually, whenever David mentioned about the Lord, parating niya sabi, the Lord is my shepherd, He makes me lie down, He leads me, He restores my soul, always on the third person. But then, when you go to verses 4 to 5, David shifts now, referring to him in the second person. Ang sinasabi niya dito, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Can we have you seen the transition? From being the third person there describing God to the second person now that telling God as if God was there right in front of him. Now you see, sabi pa ng ibang mga biblical scholars, it was like David was actually changing from making comments about God to actually telling people or telling his readers about God being so personal. Yun yung ginagawa ni David dito. And you see, he moved from making God as a third person, pointing a third person analysis, to actually making him to the second person, a personal God. It's like God was in front of him, and God was actually telling him and showing him that this is what I want for you, David. Now you see, in the shadow of this psalm alone, you would see that David actually showed us kung gaano niya kilala yung Panginoon and how close he was with the Lord. You see, when in moments such as this, there are times that whenever we talk to people, we are prone to talk more about God, about who He is, yung being niya, yung characteristics niya. And sometimes we often find that transition that when we talk about our experiences to other people, mas makita natin that we are actually fond about sharing our own experience, the things that we experience firsthand from God towards these people. And you would see that in the light of these things, this is actually a psalm where it shows that David experienced who God is. Now, David changes from making a comment about God to actually having that communion towards God. Yun yung pinagkaiba dun. And you see, there's one thing that I want us to remember tonight. There's one thing that I want us to remember tonight. That David actually knew who his God was. Kilalang kilala ni David kung sino yung Panginoon niya. And David was sure that when he was writing this psalm, he was not just writing out of experience, just because meron lang siyang na-experience in life or there was this struggle that was present. But when he was writing Psalm 23, he was writing because right then and there, his God was too personal for him. So I just want to share two things for us tonight. And the first one is this. God allows us to endure and go through valley. Meaning, God allows us to endure such pain or to go moments where it's so dark, where we have no choice but to trust our shepherd. Now you see, nung ginamit ni David yung connotation na shepherd, this was actually very known in the olden Israel time. Because people back then, yung mga works nila, prominent work was fishermen, being a shepherd. And back then, this was so familiar to them because they know what it's like to be a shepherd. Kasi madaming sheep, madaming tupa back then. And can you imagine that everything makes sense back there because David knew and those people who were listening, those people who are going to read Psalm 23 knew what a shepherd looks like. And they are very aware of that. But you see, while I was reading this, and in verse 3 and 4, it says that there is a path through the valley that's also a righteousness in which God leads. But also, there are moments in that valley where it's going to get dark. That's why David said, even though I walk to the valley of shadow of death, I will fear no evil. And habang binabasa ko ito, bakit parang nagkaroon ng transition si David? This time in verses 1 to 2, David was actually declaring that he knows his God as a shepherd. And then not only that. In verses 3 and 4, he says that God is actually the God who leads him to the path of righteousness. And then bigla siyang nag-turn or nag-shift into a reality that though God leads him to a path of righteousness, in that path alone, there is that darkness or there is that evil present. That even though he walks through the valley of shadow of death, he will fear no evil. Now, sometimes I know for a fact that in our lives, we are not fond of facing problems. We do not enjoy whenever we face problems or whenever there's a struggle. And pag pinagdadaanan natin yung mga bagay na yun, we are not fond of that. Sometimes kung pwede ka natin iwasan yung mga bagay na yan, gagawin natin. But you see, David included this in this specific psalm so that we would know, so that we would know, and those people could relate, that there would really come a time in our lives where we are going to walk in the shadow and valley of death. And that's all too familiar for us. But you see, in those moments, God allows such thing because He wanted us that as we walk on that path, we would be reminded that we are not alone. That in spite of those hazards and also those things that we are going to experience, well, we are there in those moments and on those path, many things can be developed in us. But you see, when we are walking through some unfamiliar valley and those shadows linger, like the problems that we face, the illnesses, maybe some of us are experiencing yung mga sakit, tumataas naman yung number ng COVID, some of us have anxieties, the problems that we face within our families. You see, there's this one thing that we can remember, that our shepherd appointed even this hard time as one of his path of righteousness. That there is a purpose why God allows such thing for us to go through. He's taking us to that high position for us to realize that on those dark moments, meron siyang dinidevelop for us. God wanted us to know that no good does the Lord withhold from those who walk uprightly. And not only that, katulad ng sabi ni Paul in Romans 8 verse 28, all good things work together for those who love the Lord. Because you see, we know that for those who love God, God makes it a point that He knows that everything has a purpose. Yun yung gusto ni Lord na ma-realize natin. So that whenever we experience valleys or dark moments, and we walk on those evil paths, God allows such thing to happen to us because there's a purpose. And He wanted us to know that even on those times, that's His path of righteousness. There's something within us that He wants to develop. And the second thing that I want you to remember is that you are with your shepherd. Now, this whole Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, is not just actually an ordinary psalm where David is actually giving a comfortable or a psalm of comfort to those people who's going to read it. But this is actually a promise that we can stay in God's presence because God is going to stay with us. In verse 4, it says, "Even though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me." Now you see, David here, first he speaks of God's nearness. Yung sinasabi niya dito, His presence, that when you step onto that valley, on those dark moment, it's so dark that you can't see the path. That's the moment that you can trust God because He is near with you. And not only that, that in those moments where we think that God is far away, you see, God is actively working in our very lives, just as how a shepherd would actually look for his sheep whenever a sheep is lost. Kasi yung shepherd with his staff, yun yung ginagamit niya pang lead ng mga tupa niya. And the same goes for all of us. The same goes for all of us. That whenever we think that when we go through dark moments and those path of righteousness, God shows us that He is near with us and He is the one guiding us. You see, this Psalm 23 is actually a psalm that it does not only give a psalm of comfort, but it actually gives a promise that God promises His presence for all of us. That though we may experience problems, struggles, or we may walk in the valley of shadow of death, we can, and it is very possible, to fear no evil. Why? Because we have our shepherd with us. We have our shepherd with us. And He promises that He will never leave us nor forsake us. And not only that, it was not only mentioned here that God promises His presence, but also God promises His power. You see, the one that God uses, or the one that the shepherd uses to guide His sheep, is yung staff niya. The staff is actually a figure of power. That whenever a sheep is actually walking astray, He can just easily move that sheep and guide that sheep back to that path that He wanted them to walk to. And the same goes for us. God's staff is never too short to reach to us. That when we think there are times and moments na iniisip natin, is God even real? Just because we don't think, or we think that He is not actively participating in our situation. You see, God is powerful, and His staff is not so short to reach us and lead us back to the path of His righteousness. God's promise of His presence, God's promise of His power, and thirdly, God's promise of His leading. You see, when David was actually pointing out that your staff, they will comfort me, it was actually a promise where a good shepherd would guide his sheep. When a lamb or a sheep is going to go astray, this is actually the moment where the shepherd would lead back his sheep on that path where he wanted them to walk. You see, David felt comforted that whenever a sheep would go astray, or whenever a sheep would fall into a pit, this is actually a great comfort that David gives to us, because there's a shepherd who is willing to lead us back to that path. There's a shepherd that is willing to look for us in moments where we think that we are lost. You see, God promises us His leading. And David was supremely confident, because though in that time of testing and of present circumstances, he knew and learned that God could in no other way, abandon us. He will never do that. That's why on the very start of that psalm, yung sinabi doon ni David, that the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. On those verses alone, David shows who his God was. Kasi yun yung pagkakilala niya sa Panginoon niya. He leads me in the path of righteousness for His name's sake, that even though I walk to the valley of shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Why? Because David knew that his God was powerful. He prepares a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Who would prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies? No one, but God will. He anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. And anong sabi ni David sa last? Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Now, David wanted us to understand that when the presence of the shepherd is with you, there's always that comfortable future. But you see, on the process of going to that future, there can be uncertain times. But what the shepherd promises to us is His presence, His power, and His leading. Now, young people, the truth is, I don't know what struggles you are facing right now. Maybe some of you think that you're on the valley of the shadow of death, where it's so hard to believe that God is at work. Or maybe you're thinking na your problem is too big just because you're facing that today. And you seem that, and it seems that God is not answering your prayers. But let me remind you that the God that you have and believe in is your shepherd. Is the God who promises that He will be our shepherd in moments where there we are going to walk in the valley of shadow of death. He will prepare a table before us in the presence of our enemies. But if you're going to look at the end of that psalm, He promises us that He is going to dwell with us, and we're going to dwell in His house forever. You see, this is the promise of a shepherd. The promise of a great shepherd. A father who is willing to go great lengths just to save you, to comfort you, to lead you, to protect you. He promises His presence, His power, and His leading for you and for me. So whatever it is that we are going through today, let it be a reminder for all of us that God promises His presence, His power, and His leading. Good evening, and the Lord bless you.